This really happened to me. As I was traveling home from Richmond early last evening, Sunday, July 8th, 2012, I was trying to start my trip home before the next storm hit. The area was under heavy storm warnings, and we had just had several. The weather let up, and I went out on my way, hoping to beat the next storm home. As I was getting ready to merge onto I-95 South, I noticed that on the adjoining ramp there was a car flipped on its top with a crew of emergency workers surrounding it. I prayed for the occupants and continued to merge onto the highway. I wondered how a car could find itself on its top. I thought, you know, this was not a typical place that could cause that kind of one-car accident. Just a moment later, it hit. A great crash of thunder, and rain started coming down in bullets. All at once, I realized my car was not strictly on the pavement. It was being tossed around by the winds, the high, high winds. I could hear the sounds of wind moving my car, and rain so heavy it was deafening. I noticed the other cars around me were having the same troubles. The visibility became next to nil, at which point I became afraid. I was in trouble. So I said a quick prayer, "Lord, keep me safe," and I called my boyfriend. I told him what was happening, and in a moment, trees began falling apart all around me. The winds were incredible, forceful, and loud, and everyone had moved off the highway to sit it out, so finally I decided to do the same. When it was safe, I resumed my progress to the next exit. It was a country road, without which I would not be able to make it home. It was the only such road available to me. I reminded my boyfriend, who promised to stay on the phone with me until my line went dead for lack of service, that this road was notorious for downed trees after storms and disoriented deer being hit. It was treacherous, to say the least. The next storm took control of that little country road, and again, it hit. Winds, pelting rain, and scant visibility. But there were cars behind me, and no place to stop. As the rain came and went from the left, on the right, there was a huge rainbow that came into view. It spanned the entire sky, ahead of me on one side of the road to the other, just like it had in the field of our farm when I was a little girl and had run to both ends and stood in that rainbow long ago. As I neared it, instead of seeing the normal optical illusion of the rainbow traveling farther away from me, it neared my position. As my boyfriend listened to my reaction, how awestruck I was, the rainbow traveled over my car as I passed by. I couldn't believe it. From the right to the left, the rainbow passed over my car. Then I saw another rainbow, and as I neared it, it too passed over my car. I couldn't believe it. There was a third rainbow. As soon as I had passed the second, as I neared it, it too passed over my car. This happened 7 times. 7 times! One of the rainbows passed over my car from the left side to prove to me that this was not mere optical illusion that was causing it. The 8th rainbow, yes, there were 8, merely allowed me to pass through it. The last rainbow, the 9th rainbow, came over the road I was on, and with with no other cars in front of me, it shone down my lane until the rain and wind abated. After the first rainbow passed over my car, I lost the signal on my cell phone. My boyfriend was cut off from me, and I was alone with the Lord as he brought me through this dangerous, wondrous, miraculous journey. When the ninth rainbow bent its colors down onto my lane for my car to follow them, as if they were heavenly rose petals tossed to the ground before the feet of a princess, the love of the Lord God, creator of heaven and earth, my personal creator, filled that car, and I was overwhelmed. I began to weep and thank the Lord for this precious, amazing vision of his love for me. And then he said to me, "I love you so much, Michelle, and no matter what happens, I am in control, and everything is all right." I basked in his love for me so lavish. I turned on the CD player that I had turned off in order to concentrate on the road and its dangerous conditions. This is what played.
What if you call me and don't feel me near you? Will you still trust me? What if I tell you to let go of the very thing that you think you have to hold? Will you trust me? Yes, I'll trust you, Lord. What if it costs my life? Yes, I'll trust you, Lord. What if I lose the very thing I love so dear? Yes. Somebody say, yes, I'll trust you, Lord. Somebody say, yes. Come on, put your hands up and say, yes, I'll trust you. I'll trust you. I'll trust you. I can hear Jesus singing. He says this.
I know the thing is easy. When everything is going well, but can you still believe in me when your life's a living hell? Ooh. And when all the things around you seem to quickly fade away, there's just one thing I really want to know. Will you let go?
I trust you, Lord.
Will you stand on my word?
I trust you, Lord.
Against all odds, will you believe what I have said?
I trust you, Lord.
Will you believe?
I trust you, Lord.
Every promise that I made, will you receive, my child?
Yes, I will trust you.
I know how bad. You trust that I can help you, and I'll never turn away from mine. Will you trust me, child? join in and say, every step I take, I will. In my troubled time,
I will.
In my sadness,
I will
trust you.
Try.
In all of my hurt,
I will.
I will.